So let's take a look at a technical term that I'm sure everybody knows, but it's worth taking a closer look at. And that term is GIF. Or is it GIF? Because the first thing we should ask is how to pronounce it before we even talk about what it is. Because a lot of people will say it's pronounced GIF, a lot of people say it's GIF. Probably the definitive answer is that it's GIF because the creator of the term says it's GIF. However, for years and years I pronounced it GIF before that information ever came to light, so I'm pretty much stuck for the rest of my life pronouncing it GIF, and I don't really think it matters too much. Everybody knows what you're talking about if you say GIF or if you say GIF. So moving past that, GIF is an image format. It stands for Graphics Interchange Format, and it is just basically a way of representing images digitally so that you can post them to web pages, you can post them to social media, in messages, send them in emails, whatever. It's typically thought of as a final format for images. So you would take a photograph, that would be as a raw image or JPEG image, or you do a graphic as a vector graphic in a proprietary format, or perhaps as a PNG graphic, and then you would export as GIF to get a nice compression and something that can be easily used on a web page or wherever. So GIFs were on the scene very early on before the web. 1987 is when they first appeared on CompuServe. And since then they've gained wide use and support. So pretty much anything, a browser, image editing apps, messaging apps, anything can display a GIF image. They do have a small file size. And the way they accomplish this is that instead of using just any color for pixels, every image is examined and 256 colors are chosen as the colors to use for every pixel. So you can represent every pixel with a number between 0 and 255 rather than having red, green, and blue values for every single pixel. That's what makes it pretty small, but it also limits its quality. Now, animation is a big part of GIFs, and it's why they persist even though they're not the best format for regular images. See, as regular images, JPEG always wins when it comes to photographs. You could see here some parts of the photograph on the left, the GIF image, look about the same as the JPEG, like the cherries for instance or the strawberries. But if you look at, say, the apples near the top, you can see that there's a lot of pixelation when it comes to the GIF, and JPEG looks better. And in addition, this JPEG image here, and I've blown these both up about three times so you can see the pixels, the JPEG image is actually smaller in file size, so it wins in every respect. Now when it comes to graphics, a format like GIF can be better. You notice the field of red in the middle of this apple, and a drawn graphic is nice and red, whereas the JPEG, it's pixelated because it's trying to represent it as an image. So GIF can be better. These are both about the same image size. Now, PNG will get you exactly the same as the GIF. It may actually be smaller, and it at least is a tie for the best format for graphics. GIF does shine over JPEG in terms of being transparent. You can have pixels that are transparent and see-through, whereas JPEG you cannot. But notice that the pixels around the border, they either are transparent or they're not. So the pictures around the border here are basically fading to white, which creates a white halo since it's on a dark background. So transparency only works really well if there's a very nice solid edge to the image, or if you already know the background color of the background that the image is going to go on. PNG can be transparent and can do a much better job. Doesn't completely get rid of like halos and things like that. You can see a little bit around here, but it's a much smoother transparency for graphics like this. But where GIFs really do shine, of course, are animated GIFs. And basically the term GIF has become synonymous with animated GIFs. People will say, look at this GIF, or I'm going to post a GIF, or I posted a GIF. And what they really mean are animated GIFs. And there are tons of websites like this one that allow you to basically grab animated GIFs, usually made from TV, movies, and you know, YouTube videos, things like that. And they're short, tiny little clips because you really can only include very few frames in a kind of loop to show a quick animation. There's no audio included, but very often these are used to either make somebody laugh or to show an emotion instead of actually typing out how you feel. So you can use these in messages. You can use these on posts on social media. A lot of times it's very easy to actually search for and find these. For instance, in messages in iOS, you can easily search for and find a GIF right inside of the Messages app and post it. So it's very easy to do. And you can also make your own. So you can, you know, in the App Store, for instance on the Mac, you can find tons of apps that will convert your videos and convert even your burst photos and things like that to animated GIFs that you can then post. And they would be unique because you would be the one creating them. And you could find apps as well that do this on iOS.